Chapter 8 Earthquakes. What do you mean by earthquakes? An earthquake is defined as a tremor below the surface of the earth which causes shaking of the crust. These devastating tremors are caused by the stresses that break the earth's crust and also due to the movement of plate tectonics. Now, what causes earthquakes? First of all, a series of shocks that result from sudden earth movement, example along a fault, are called earthquake waves or seismic waves. Now, the factors which cause earthquakes are volcanoes. Volcanic eruptions are one of the main causes of the earthquake. When the volcanic eruptions happen, hot gases are pushed upward and they push violently the earth's crust surface, leading to the earthquakes. The second is plate tectonics. According to the plate tectonic theory, the crust of the earth is made of a series of movable plates. So due to the shaking of the crust, when these plates move, it causes an earthquake. Folding and faulting. Internal horizontal and vertical movements due to compressional and tensional forces cause folding and faulting in the earth's crust. This causes displacement of rocks in the crust. Such an imbalance causes the earthquakes. Now, there are some man-made causes of earthquakes as well. Some human activities such as construction of dams, nuclear explosions, blasting of rocks, mining and so on near fault zones in the earth are responsible for earthquakes. One earthquake in Maharashtra, that is Koyna earthquake, was caused by the construction of Koyna Dam in a seismically active region. Now, what is an anatomy of an earthquake? The vibrations travel in three types of waves: P waves, that is primary waves, S waves, secondary or shear waves, and L waves, long waves or surface waves. Primary waves are also known as push waves. They can pass through all states of matter including solids, liquids and gases. These waves are the first earthquake waves which are recorded on a seismogram of an earthquake. Next is secondary waves or shear waves. These are recorded on a seismogram after the P waves. They cannot be transmitted through liquids. They are also called shear waves and they are distortional waves in which the particles vibrate at right angles to the direction of movement of the wave. Last comes the L waves, which are surface waves or long waves. They travel along the surface of the earth and are recorded after the P and S waves. There are two types of L waves, Love waves and Rayleigh waves. The P and S waves, they travel to the interior of the earth. The surface waves are the last to arrive. Now, how do we measure earthquakes? There are three instruments used for measuring earthquakes. These are seismograph, Richter scale and Mercalli scale. They measure the intensity of the earthquakes. What is a seismograph? The direction of movement of waves and their passage at a particular point is recorded by an instrument called seismograph. It has a pen attached to it. Thus, due to the vibration of the earth, the pen also vibrates with the earthquake waves, recording their movements on a traveling strip of paper. Next is the Richter scale. Now, both Richter scale and Mercalli scale are used to measure the intensity of the earthquake. The Richter scale measures the power of an earthquake on a scale of 1 to 9. The Assam earthquake in India of 1897 was of 8.7 magnitude. The Gujarat earthquake in 2001 had the magnitude of only 7.7 on the Richter scale, yet it caused a great damage. Also, there were earthquakes occurring in Nepal. It left many people homeless. It also destroyed centuries-old buildings including UNESCO World Heritage Sites in Kathmandu Valley. Now, what are the effects of the earthquake? Earthquake cause both constructive as well as destructive effects. Some constructive effects are, they help in the release of energy stored inside the earth. The majority of the earthquakes occur around the plate margins. Thus, energy release helps to keep the earth in good shape. And also, there is a creation of landforms. on account of both vertical and lateral displacement of the Earth's crust, earthquakes may raise to or lower parts of Earth, especially near the seashore. Now, there are destructive effects as well. It includes collapse of many structures, submergence, that is Dwarka in Gujarat, which now lies submerged under the sea. Course of rivers, it leads to change in the course of rivers. Obviously, there is danger to human life as well. It causes landslides, fires and tsunamis, and also flash floods. A tsunami struck Java and Sumatra in Indonesia on 2nd December 2018, resulting in more than 300 deaths. The tsunami was likely caused by undersea landslides due to the ongoing eruption of Anak Krakatoa volcano called in the Sunda Strait. Finally, the distribution of the earthquakes. The main earthquake belts of the world include the Circum-Pacific Mountain Belt. This belt has 70% of all the earthquakes present in the world. A part of San Andreas Fault in the USA lies in this belt. This fault zone makes California and USA highly prone to earthquakes. The area of Japan, the Philippines, and Indonesia all form parts of this belt and are prone to severe earthquakes. Second is the Midworld Mountain Belt. It stretches from Eastern Europe, covering Alpine Himalayan ranges in Europe and Asia. About 20% of all earthquakes occur in this zone. And last is the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. It comprises areas along the mid-oceanic ridges, and 10% of the earthquakes occur in this belt. In this ridge, two tectonic plates move in opposite direction. And the last is predicting earthquakes. What do you think? Can we predict earthquakes? Earthquake prediction in the past was left to astrologers and mystics, but today it is a respectable scientific pursuit. The Russians were the first to discover P and S waves in 1960s. These waves still are the only means available to seismologists for predicting the earthquakes. The theory of plate tectonics offers another means of prediction on scientific lines. Japanese use the methods of measuring changes in sea level and variations in Earth's magnetic field to predict the earthquakes. However, no official method is still foolproof that has been approved by recent earthquakes in Japan, India and USA. What are the key points? The point of origin of the seismic waves is known as the seismic focus. The point on the Earth's surface above seismic focus is called the epicenter. Seismic waves pertain to earthquakes. Also, tsunami are the ripples and storms in oceans generated by oceanic earthquakes. Thank you for watching.